Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, this channel is dedicated to WordPress and WooCommerce stuff so that you can make yourself business solutions that are worthwhile. In today's video, I'm going to help you understand what categories or taxonomies are, how to create one, how to remove some of these fields that are actually showing up here, and how to actually add your own fields inside this particular space. So what are these taxonomies? Taxonomies are basically a tool that you use in WordPress to help you classify your different posts, because WordPress just works with different post types. For example, we have a post, post type, we have a pages, post type, we have products, post type, which is basically a custom post type. But you might want to get those different post types or different posts and then group them in different ways. For example, so the taxonomy that we're looking at is actually one that's coming from the WooCommerce custom products. But if you go to posts, you'll be able to see that we actually have a category that is here. So we have that categories, which is basically what we call in WordPress as a taxonomy. So you will see that it has these same fields showing up: the name, the slug, the parent category, and then also the description. Yet, when we go to the tags, you'll see that we have only the name, the slug, and the description. So one of the big differences that there are is that categories are hierarchical in nature, so meaning they can have a parent, they can have children, while tags themselves do not have children. So you cannot have a parent for a tag. So if you're interested in seeing this or seeing these different ideas all put together, then let's jump into the video. So you could have products, let's say in a shop, and those particular products are grouped under t-shirts. So that would be a nice place to have a taxonomy for t-shirts, so that you can have Adidas t-shirts, or you have different brands all together that are grouped under that t-shirts category. So since WordPress offers us this platform, we can be able to create new taxonomies with our different post types, or we can be able to even add different taxonomies to the existing post types, like posts and pages that we already have. So let's look at how WooCommerce uses its products and how it uses the different categories and tags and attributes coming from the taxonomies. So you'll see that WooCommerce uses these categories. For example, in my shop, I have t-shirts, I have deco, I have things like drinks, I have things like music, soups, and those are ways I can group the different products that I have inside my custom post type. So the first thing that we are going to do, we are going to create our own custom post type, and I'm just going to run to the dev notes of WordPress. So I'll go to WordPress. So I'll go look at the register post type functionality that is in WordPress, and you'll see that we have different things. We have provide like labels, descriptions. Is it hierarchical in nature, so that you can have different items as children or as parents, post types? And I'm just going to scroll all the way down. I'm just going to get this sample post type, which is of a book that I need to get here. I'll come back to my server. I'm going to go in WP Content, Plugins, and then I'm going to create a completely new plugin, which I'm going to call Taxonomies Exhibit. And then I'll drag and drop this into my editor. And now I'm ready to start adding my own files. So I'll say taxonomies exhibit, and I'll make it a .php file. Start it off with a .php. Then I'll use my start plugin shortcut or snippet that will help me fix all these things that I need to. So plugin name, I'll say taxonomies exhibit. And then I'll change the author URI link to my github.com/pyttechiepress/taxonomies-exhibit. And then of course I'll add my name, which is techiepress, and I'll say showing what taxonomies can do, showing what taxonomies can do for you. in WordPress. I'll give this a version of 0.1. I'll license this under GPL2 or later, so that people can fork it and use it. Then I'll just use the same text domain here and paste it here. So once this is done, I'll save this. I'm going to come back to my admin in here, go to the plugins. I'll activate the taxonomies exhibit plugin, and then I'll just deactivate these others. So I'll go back to my code, and then I'm going to paste what we copied already from the other side over WordPress. I'll save this, and then let's go back here and reload. If you want to know what each one of these particular arguments or the pieces that we are putting in here to have this post type, then you can watch the video that is in the card that has just appeared on the screen, or check the description to actually see it. You'll now see that we now have this books post type that has come in. And if I go to click on the books post type, you'll just see it has only books, and it has add new that will allow us to add new books. But let's say I want to have genres in my books. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to our documentation inside WordPress, and then what I'm going to do is register taxonomy. And it is right here. So in here you'll see that you have different parameters, like what you will call the taxonomy, the object type, and then you provide the arguments that will be used inside that particular taxonomy. So it would be good for you to just go and read this and see what's going on. Or if you want to learn how to add your own taxonomies, you can also check the video that is in the card that has just showed up, or in the description below to see a video that I made explaining all the different labels and the arguments on how to create your own taxonomy. But we're going to see a sample of the code running inside our own plugin. So let me just use what we have here. I'll expand this, and you'll see that this is also going to be creating genres for our book post type. So I'm going to copy this code here. I'll come back here, and then I'm going to say add taxonomy for genres. Of course, this is going to be a comment, and then I'll paste this code. I'm going to save this. So this code that we've imported has two taxonomies that it registers. One is for writer and the other is for genre. So right now what I want to do, I'll save this. Let's go back and see what will happen. If I reload this, you're going to see that we now have a genre and we also have writers. So let's say we have books that are fictional, we can be able to add them in the fictional genre here. So we have fictional. The slug will automatically populate itself, and we say books for fictional writing. So I'll add this as a new genre, and you'll see that it's actually in here. So what I'm going to do is I'll say action fiction, and I'll say this one is going to have a parent genre of fictional, and I'll say fiction with action genre. I'll add that, and you'll see that this is, it's put at a level below the fictional right here. So if we go back to our books and we're adding a new book, you're going to see that our WordPress actually provides us with this fictional genre that we can choose, or we can add this to the action fiction option. Now I know this looks a little bit weird. This is the old way of writing WordPress. This is what we call the classic editor. And the reason is because while I was writing my custom post type, I did not allow the arguments in here to factor in for what we know as the REST API showing. So I'm going to just duplicate this, and I'm going to add a new option, which is show in REST. And then instead, and I'll just clean this out so that they're on the same level. And I'm going to choose here and say this should be true. So if I go back to my actual page here and reload it, you will see that this actually comes with the new editor look right here. you'll actually see that we don't have our books, we don't have our genres and writers here, we just have a few of these limited options. So what I'm going to do is also just go and show in REST my particular taxonomies. So I'll come back here in the arguments, I'll add show in REST to make it true, and then I'm also going to show this as well in REST. So save this, come reload, and now you'll see that we have the option for genre here, and we can choose these two, or you can add it in any of these, and then you can also be able to add a writer. Let's say we're going to say this is a John Grisham writing, so John Grisham. When I press enter, you'll see that actually this is a tag that has come in. So I can also add a new genre and say maybe this is romance. And you'll see that we can be able to check off any of these particular items. So I'm just going to go back to our code here, and I'm going to remove this taxonomy that is not hierarchical, and that's why you see that in here it came as a tag. But if I was to change this hierarchical to true and save it, come back here and reload, I'll leave this page, you'll actually now see that the writers are being shown as this category that we had here. It's no longer just a tag. Now, you remember when I was explaining to you earlier, this is the difference. If it's hierarchical, then it will allow you to have a parent and a child kind of relationship. But if it is actually false, like we have here as in hierarchical nature, and you reload this, you're actually going to realize that this is going to just be a tag. So when we reload this, you'll see that our writers are actually just what we have here as tags. So I can add new tags and say John. As I type here, you'll see that we have the John Grisham showing up, and you can have that all there. So let's just focus on having our genre here, and then we're going to see how we can actually affect this inside our WordPress. So I'm going to come back to our code, I'm going to get this writer block that we have here, I'll remove it, save this, come back to make sure we've not broken anything, I'll reload it. You'll now see that we only have our genre showing up here. I'm going to step back a little bit, and you'll see that now we only have genre here. So let me click on the genre, and you'll see these particular fields that are available. Now, one of the challenges that we have is that these particular fields cannot be taken away by a simple hook. So the only way we can do this is by using something like JavaScript to hide these particular fields and not have them, or we can even use CSS to just hide them, but there's no particular way of removing them inside WordPress using a simple hook. I really hope in the future this is going to change. This is one of those things that I want to submit a ticket for, but it will be a little bit complex to do in order of implementation, and it might not be one of those priority areas for the core team development right now. But let's see how we can remove this using JavaScript. So I'm going to remove this description box that we have here in our genres so that we don't have it at all. So I'll come back to our code here, I'll go down here, and I'm going to say remove the description field in the genre taxonomy. So let's see how to handle this with JavaScript. So the first thing that I'm going to do is add an action here, and the action that I'm looking at is I want to use what we call the admin underscore footer. Now, inside this admin underscore footer, we want to run a function. I'm going to call this function techiepress underscore remove genre fields, and then I'll copy this right here. I'll come here and say function with this name, I'll add our brackets, I'll add our curly brackets as well, and then press enter here. Of course, I'll space this just to make it easier for me to read. And inside this function, we're going to be having some JavaScript. So the first thing I'll do is escape our PHP and then open it as well. so that I can be able to write script in here, which is HTML, and say this will be a type of, and I'll say that's equal to, of course, in here I'll say it's going to be a text slash JavaScript. Now I need to end this as well and then close off that script so that we have good HTML. Now inside this script, what I'm going to use is jQuery, which comes bundled inside WordPress, and I'll say inside our jQuery, let's go to the document and make sure that this document has loaded. So we'll use the document.ready function in here, and then here I'll say let's have a function, and this function is going to run all our different things that we want to do, but we are going to pass in the dollar sign so that we can reference it as jQuery inside our code. So I'll say, using this dollar sign, let us get the particular ID of this field. So I'll come back inside here, I'm going to inspect this element, and we'll see that it has an ID of tag description. But I don't want to only get this item, I want to get this whole div right here. So I am going to just get this tag-description and get its parent. So inside our code, what does that look like? We're going to say we're getting the ID of tag-description. Make sure you spell it very well. And then we're going to say we need to get the parent item, and then we're going to use the remove to remove that. So I'll save this. We're going to come back in here. I'll give this a reload. And you will see that that takes away that particular item. Now you can do the same thing to remove the slug. So I'll just inspect it and see what ID it has. So we have tag slug. We also have, if we wanted to take away this whole concept of parent genres, we can come back here and say we want to get the ID of parent. So let me just take out the tag slug, because the beauty about removing this tag slug is we don't have to be so worried, because WordPress itself always gives us the slug that we can use here. It automatically generates it. Now you can see that the genre fields here have all gone, and if I go back to the posts here and then go to the categories, you will see that we're having the same issue down here. But I don't want that to be the case. I want it to only apply to the genres here. And we come here and use the global. We're going to tap into the global and say we want to get the current screen. This is actually a WordPress functionality. I'm going to just say let's var dump this so that we can see the current screen. I'll save this. Let's go back to our front page. Let's reload this. I'm going to inspect this item here. So this admin wrap, all I'm going to do is just say position fixed, I'll remove that, and you'll be able to see that we're looking at the parent file in here, we're looking at the post type here which we can get, and then we can get all these different items like the ID of edit genre. So what I'm going to do here is come back and say, so we're going to say if our current screen is actually equal to edit genre, so I'll put this in a string, and I'll say if it's equal to the current screen, and here we're going to say edit dash genre. If it is equal to that, then we're going to run this particular code. So I'm going to get everything that's in here, and I'm going to shift it up one level. So I'll save this. Let's come back here. I'll give this a hard reload. On a reload, you'll see that this is still showing, and that's because in my code, I said let the edit genre equal to the current screen, but we just wanted to actually map the ID from the current screen, and we say let this equal to the edit genre. So I'm going to come back here and reload this, and you'll now see that this has disappeared here, but if I go to the post categories, you'll see that they still show up. If I go to the products, go to the categories, you'll actually see that these actually show up. So I'll go back to my genre inside the books here, and we still see that we have the slug showing up here, we have the description showing up here. Now we can use the manage columns in here to remove this particular items if we do not need them, if we do not need to show them, if they're going to confuse our particular users, we can actually remove them. So how do we do that? So we'll come back to our code, and this time we're going to use a filter function, and I'm going to say here remove column for description. And what we're going to do in this case, we're going to tap the manage, we're going to use the manage, edit, and then here we say dash, we give the name of the particular post type or the particular taxonomy that we are working with, and then we're going to say underscore columns. Now after doing that, we're going to write a function here. So we'll open a new function here, which I'll call techiepress underscore remove genre columns. I'll copy this and then I'll start up the function here. We'll add our curly brackets to write our function. So every time we use a filter, it basically gives us something to work with. And this particular filter gives us the columns. So I'm going to write this variable columns, and I'm going to say we need to return our columns as of first importance. So I'll add a semicolon here, and then what we're going to do here is use an if statement. Of course, in here we're going to say if we actually have a column, so if the columns, and we're going to say if in our columns we actually have a description column, we're going to say if that is true, then we're just going to get this description column, copy it here, and we're going to say unset, and that's a function of PHP. We're going to say unset columns right here, then you return the columns. So let's go back to our genres, I'll reload this, and you'll now see that we don't have any description showing up here. So we could do the same thing even for the slug if we don't want it, so I just need to duplicate this and say slug. I know you're wondering how I am getting this, but by default most of these things are the same, or you can actually go inside the WordPress core files and you'll be able to see the names that these have, or you can actually just come and inspect these items and you'll see most of them have the IDs already shown in there. So I'll reload this and you'll see that our slug actually goes away. So we have something that's neat and clean right here, and that's all we wanted. So what does it take for us to have our own fields in this particular space? It's quite simple. There is actually a particular hook that we can use that comes after this form that can allow us to save different items or different fields under this space. So that's what I'm going to work on next. If you're interested in it, then let's continue with the video. So we're going to use a new action hook, and the hook that we are looking for is what we call the add form fields. Now what happens is that this is going to require the taxonomy that you want to add this particular field, and in our case the taxonomy we have here is called genre. So I just need to come back here and add genre and add an underscore. So after doing that, I'll add a comma, and then we'll start writing our function, which I'll say techiepress underscore add genre fields. So this will be the name of the function that I'm going to create here. So function techiepress add genre fields. I'll add our curly brackets, and inside here we are now going to write some particular HTML. So I'll have to escape our PHP, open the PHP here as well, and then here we're going to have a div. The div will have a class of form-fields. I'll press enter, and I am basically getting this whole structure from what we had before. So if I come back here to the front end and I inspect this element, you'll see that it has a form-field class right here. So I'm going to be adding a form-field. I'll need to correct this, and it's going to be right under that parent genre, but just above the button. So I'm going to come back here, I'll change this to form-field so that we have a uniform class, and then here we shall have a label. The label is going to be for our genre characterization, And that's basically going to explain, it's going to be a short film that explains what our particular genre has as the biggest characterization of it all. So I'm going to copy this right here, and we're going to have an input that's going to be a type of text. So it will have a name of genre characterization. I'll give it the same ID also here, and then I'll decide to have a paragraph that is going to explain what we are talking about. So every genre has a particular characterization of it. For example, so e.g., if we have fiction, we can say it is lies. So I'll save this. Let's come back to our front end. I'll reload here. And you'll see we have this box explaining this. The only thing we don't have is we forgot to add our particular label in here. So I'll change this to characterization. Save this. I'll come back to this place and then I'll reload it here. And you'll see that we have characterization and we can add our particular items here. So we'll have characterization in this particular space. Now I'm going to come back to the genre that we have here, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a new field. I'm going to add a new columns field. So I'll add a column and then I'm going to say this is going to be for characterization. I'll just copy this. I'll make sure this is in lowercase just to be like all the others up. And then I'll say that's going to equal to, and I'll just copy this right here, copy this, paste it here, and we shall say we want to have characterization. So let me come back here, I'll reload, and you'll now see that we have this new field here that shows the characterization in here. So we'll be able to add the different characterizations once we add them to this particular spot. So I'm going to come back to my code here, and now we need to be able to save that particular line of lies if we want to have it in here. All we've done is just added the field. Now we need to be able to save the form field that we have added to our code. And the way we do that is we have an action, and the action that we are looking for starts off with created underscore, and we need to add the particular taxonomy that we are using. So we have genre here, and then we're going to add a new function in here, and I'll say this is techiepress created genre fields, and I'll copy this here and add a new function with this. I'll add the curly brackets. This particular action hook actually gives us the term ID. So I'm going to get this and say we're going to update the term meta. And all we need to do is we need to pass in the term ID in here, which we have done so. We need to add in the meta key, the meta value, and the previous value is usually optional. So I'm just going to focus on the meta key that we want to have. And that meta key that we're going to have is this genre characterization, which I'll copy here. And I'm going to replace here as a string. And then we want to be able to pass in the new meta value. And at this spot, we're going to use $post. And this comes from PHP. So whenever we have a form that we are posting and we submit it, PHP allows us to use this post to capture some of those fields that are already in the form. So I'm just going to make sure I'm capturing the right item, and that is going to be from this ID of genre characterization. So I'll pass that in the post here. We don't need this value, the previous value, that is optional. And since this information is actually going in our database, we need to sanitize it. So I'm going to use a default WordPress function, which is called sanitize underscore text field, and it's going to take in a string of this particular information. So I'll cut this, and then I'm going to pass it in here so that we can sanitize whatever we are adding here, and then WordPress will clean it out to make sure that our database is not corrupted by the information that we have here. So I'm going to save that. And then I'll come back here to our front page. I'll reload what we have here. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to add fantasy as our new genre. It will have a characterization of dreams. So we'll say dream world. That will be the characterization. I'll click add genre. And you're going to see that our fantasy is added here, but we do not have the characterization actually showing down here. So that's something we need to fix in our code as well to be able to show what happens in here. So I'll come back to our code. I'm just going to come back here under columns, and I'm going to add info to the new columns. That's what we're going to be looking for. And then here I'm going to just say add new fields to genre. So under here is where we're going to add the new info to our columns. So here we're going to use an action, and here we're going to use a WordPress hook, which is manage underscore, and we're going to add our genre, which is the name of our taxonomy. And then after doing that, we're going to say custom underscore columns. Now that will allow us to use our own function to run our code. And our function will be techiepress. And I'm just going to copy this so that it's easy for me to follow through and paste it here and say manage genre custom columns. And then I'll come here and add the new function, and I'll add our brackets. Now in here, we'll be able to have three different kinds of arguments. One will have a string, which is usually empty, and then we shall have the columns, and then we shall also be able to access the term underscore ID. That is for the term that we are passing through that particular column. Now that means we need to pass a priority here, which I'll choose 10, and I'll also say we're going to pass three arguments that we have given inside this particular function. This three is very important. If you forget it, you'll actually find that you're having errors in your code, or your site will break. So make sure you have the priority and the number of arguments you're passing to this function. Now, once we get here, I'm just going to use an if statement, or I can use a switch. So let me use a switch for some difference. And what we're going to pass here in the switch is we're going to pass in the columns. And we shall say, whenever we are in the column that we have actually called characterization here, we're going to pass it here. All we want to do is we want to echo the term ID. I'm going to first of all add the term ID, which needs to be a variable that is proper. So I'll add the dollar sign here. And then I'm going to say dash characterization. That's what I want to pass. And then for the default, we shan't pass any default. So we just want to have that case and then break it. I'll just make sure that everything we have here is correct. We add our action, which is manage genre custom column, not columns. Add our three arguments. We have a switch statement that passes in the case. I'll echo the term ID characterization, then break. I'll save this. And when I reload, you'll see that we actually have the different term IDs showing up here, and we have dash characterization. So this is good. Now, all we need to do here in our term ID, we're going to use a WordPress function that says get term meta. And this requires us to actually pass the term ID that we already have here. We're going to pass in the key, and we're going to make sure that it is single. So we'll pass in true here. Then our key is going to be a string of genre characterization. I'll just clean everything else out here. And that means we're going to be getting this term meta that we saved here inside this particular ID. So I'll save this. We'll come back here, reload everything. And you'll see that we have our dream world that we saved here, and we have our fantasy. So if I click edit here, you will see that we don't have our characterization box anymore. In order to show that field right here, you can see the description we had removed before is still showing. That's because on this particular page, we did not remove it. So we shall get the screen ID, and we'll also remove it from here. But we're now going to first add our field that we need to have here. So what I'm going to do is come back here. In this particular case, we use the add form fields. Now we are going to duplicate this code and we're going to say add the field to the edit screen. And what we shall do here is we're going to change this part that says add. In these particular cases, I'm going to change them to edit so that we have genre, edit, form fields, and then we shall have this form field with this particular text. So let me save this. Let's go back here, I'll reload. And you're actually going to see that we have our characterization here. We have all this information coming in right here. Now, of course, this particular structure changes, so we need to copy what we have here. I'm going to inspect the element so that we can be able to see what's happening here, and then we shall add it properly. So we have a table in the form, we are having all these different pieces of information in the different table heads. So we need to fix this HTML first so that everything can work the way we expect it to. So the one thing that I'm going to do is edit this as HTML. I'll copy what we have here, and then I'm going to come back here, and then I'll be able to edit it accordingly. So I'll paste this. I'll tap this to go in a little bit. So we have the form field. We are not going to require this. And then the next thing that we shall do is add a label in the table head. So I'm going to just grab this, cut it, and I'm going to paste it here as the label. We are now going to go for the input field that we have here with the ID and of course the type and the name. I'll just cut this and replace the name, ID and type right here. We'll have the value, which is going to always be dynamic. So I'll remove that, I'll leave the area required true, we don't need that. I'll leave this at size 40, just like it is with the other parts. And then of course I'll get what we have here as our string. I'll remove everything that we have here, and then I'll paste our description right here. So I'm going to save this, let's come back, reload this, and you'll see that it properly fits in here like a nice shoe. So we have this working very well. But the only problem now that we have is we don't have our text of Dreamworld showing up here coming from the database. So we need to fix that. Now, when we come back to this particular action, we'll take a priority of 10 and we're going to get two arguments from it. So the two arguments we get are the term, and then we're also going to get the taxonomy. Now, with this term, we can be able to get the ID, we can be able to get the different things that we need. Now, in order to get this same information that we are having in our input here, we need to get term meta. And that's going to require the term ID, it's going to require the key, it's also going to require to see if it's single. So I'm going to comment this out. And what I want to do first and foremost here is just var-dump. And what I'm going to var-dump is our term so that we can see how we get the term ID. So I'll paste this here, save it. I'll come back here, I'll reload this. And you're going to see that we have the term ID showing up here. We have the name slug and all the different things here. So I'm just going to get the term ID. So I'm going to just uncomment this out. We're going to look for the term, and then we're going to map on the term ID, and we're going to make sure that what we have here as the key is going to be the general characterization, which I'll pass as a string here, and we're going to say this needs to be true. So I'll comment this out, we don't need it anymore. I'm going to save this as a value. And I'll say our value is going to equal to this. And then what I will do in this particular case, inside our input, we're going to bring back the value attribute. We'll say that is actually going to equal to our value that we have here. So I'll copy this. I'm going to wrap it inside PHP. because that's all PHP, then I'll say echo, and then I'll have our value here. But to make this nice and WordPress friendly, I'm going to escape the attributes so that we are sanitizing this very well. And then I'll save this, and let's go back to our front end. I'll reload here, and you're now going to see that we have our Dreamworld showing up here. But if I change this from Dreamworld to Dreams and update, you're going to see that it's not updating anymore. So what I'll do is I'll come back to our code here, and then I'm going to look at this particular section where we said created genre. I'll duplicate it, and we're going to say edited genre, and we shall just use the same function that we have here to do the same work. So I'll come back here, reload this, I'll change this to Dreams, I'll click update, and you'll see that we have Dreams here. If I go back to our genre, you're going to see that we have this as Dreams in this section. If I change from Romance, we'll say this is Love, I'll click update, you see Love is stored. If I go back to same categories, you'll see that our Love is under our categorization. So this is working the way we want it to. Apart from this little part of the description that's still showing up. So let me go back to our code up here, and I'm going to look for a different screen in this particular case. So I'm going to just VDump the current screen so that we can see where we are at. So I'll reload this. We have our information, but I'm going to inspect the admin back. I'll click this fixed. I'll close this off, and I'll scroll down here, and you'll see we are on the same edit genre. I'll just right click this to inspect this element. You'll see now here we have it as ID as description. We need to get the parent and get rid of it. So I'll just duplicate this, and we're just going to get description in this place. Comment out the VDump, we don't need it. I'll reload this here, and you're going to see that now we don't have that description showing up, but again, we still have this table row, so I need to be able to get this term description wrap as the ID that I am going to actually just take out. So let me right click this to edit and get the class of term description wrap. I'll just change it here, class, and I'm going to remove the parent because we don't need the parent. I'll just say remove that, and then let's see what happens. I'll reload this, and we don't have it there because we targeted the class of term description wrap and we removed it. So everything is working like we wanted it to be. We have our perfect genre showing up. We have the characterization, we can edit it, we can do different things all together inside our particular WordPress, and we're not using any other plugins, so we are doing very well, and that's all we wanted to do. If you enjoyed this video, if you think it actually has content that benefited you, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend who needs it, make sure that you subscribe for other WordPress interesting stuff. Otherwise, enjoy whatever you're building.